scriptures, we read that you must always observe dharm. But in the same scriptures, from the same scriptures, we learn about many personalities who broke the rules of dharm. They disobeyed the rules of dharm. And so the mind becomes confused. What are we supposed to do when these great ones are breaking the rules? Then how is it that we are expected to follow dharm? Well, dharm means that which is worthy of being accepted. And there are many varieties of dharm, that there are many, many virtues that come under dharm. At one point in the scriptures, it is said that the greatest dharm is to tell the truth. Another place it says that to help others is the greatest dharm. And the mind becomes confused. What is dharm? In a nutshell, there are two varieties of dharm. One is sharirik dharm, one is bhagavata dharm. Because we are a combination of two. We have a body and we are the atma, the soul. So there are two different varieties of dharm. One is for the body, the other is for the spirit soul. The one that is for the body, it is called varnashram dharm. This dharm teaches us what we should do, depending on whether we are Brahman, whether we are born in the Brahman family, Kshatriya, Vaishya, or Shudra family, and at which stage of life we are at, whether we are in Brahmacharya, or Grihastha, or Vanaprastha, or Sannyas. But at the same time, scriptures tell us, that God tells us, that Varnashram Dharm rules. He says, Varnashram Dharm rules were prescribed by me so that society in general may function properly. So that everyone doesn't become a farmer, so that everyone doesn't become a teacher, so that everyone doesn't become a warrior. So there are four different castes, depending on a person's mentality and ability. Some are more interested in scholarly learning. These are the Brahmins. And some are more physically, they're stronger physically. These are the Kshatriyas, the warriors. Some have a good business sense. So it's natural for them to be in business or to become farmers. And there are others who are very good in general labor. So these are the Shudras. Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. So that everyone may perform a different function. So there are different people performing different functions in order to keep society running. So the Varnashram Dharm is for the body. It is prescribed for the body, not for the soul, not for us. This is why when Bhagawan Ram said to Mother Sita, Sita, do not insist on coming with me on exile. You have not been exiled, I have. I'll be back in 14 years. But you must follow your dharma. Your dharma is sadar sasa sasurapad puja. You must serve your mother-in-law and father-in-law. You are a married woman and this is your dharma. Sita ji blatantly disobeyed Bhagwan Ram and she did not care about this dharma. She said, nothing doing, I'm coming with you. And as we all know, she went with Bhagwan Sri Ram, her divine husband.